The 14th of the 3rd. Makes sense.
Oh, great, great one.
You seem really enthusiastic.
Yep.
Oh, I need to tell you about pie. You don't know a range
jacket. I
think so. I'm looking forward to it.
I love it. I just love it. Some of you have so curiously asked, why am I wearing a pie shirt? And what does Pi Day actually mean? Why is it special? Let me tell you one of the many reasons why Pi Day is special.
Wait, is Pi Day once a year or like every
week? It's once a year.
Pi Day.
No, I just don't make the public call.
Yeah, yeah. So one of the reasons why it's special is I want you to think about one of the first things you ever learned when you were looking at maths and numbers, like the most basic skill that you were taught. What was one of the first
counting
things? Counting, right? Mm-hmm. Counting. These kind of building blocks, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. And that was the same for the ancient civilization as well. They learned to count things, you know, objects or people, right? But at some point they realized that wasn't enough to describe all the numbers they knew. They started seeing things like this. What have we got here?
Fractions,
right? They saw these parts of things, right? And fractions, we can only write them as something like this, because when you put this in your calculator, 2 divided by 3, you're going to get something that looks like this. 0.666666. And that kind of goes on forever. But the interesting thing is that it's repeating, isn't it? Right? It goes on forever and it's repeating. That's all well and fine until those people, they encountered numbers that they couldn't represent as fractions. Okay. And we call them the irrational numbers. And that's where things like pi and root 2 come in. Okay. And the interesting thing about these kind of numbers, is even though that they go on forever, they actually never repeat. They never repeat. Let me say that again. Never ending, never repeating number sequence. Okay. And that means tucked away something like this, those never-ending, never-repeating number sequences, is your phone password, your date of birth, even your bank card details. Everything is in there. And let me take that a step further. If we convert these numbers into letters, and you can do that on the computer, something called ASCII, right? You'd have every essay you've ever written, every message you've ever sent, every word you've ever spoken. And that's profound, because we can write it in something as simple as root 2. That's why Pi Day is special.